So you see, we have got this acceleration of the electron is given by small e by m, and in place of E, if you write down potential difference, then it is coming E V by M L. That one we have got in the last lesson, isn't it? And we have got this also, drift velocity is A into the relaxation time, average relaxation time. So if you substitute A, then you are getting E big E by M into tau. Now E, tau and M, I have written it within bracket. Why? Because you see, for a particular electron, E is constant, small e is constant, the charge of electron. Tau is the average relaxation time, which depends on the temperature. As we are not changing the temperature, so we can consider it is also constant, and m mass of electron, it is constant. So I can write this way, that drift velocity, this term within bracket, we are writing it as mu e. How we are writing? Mu e, and this is known as, this is a constant which is known as mobility of an electron. Alright, so you see from this one what we are getting, mobility of an electron is defined as drift velocity developed per unit electric field. Alright, what is mobility of an electron? What I said, drift velocity developed per unit electric field. It means that if you consider that electric field is 1 volt per meter, then you see mu e is equal to Vd. Alright, so how you can write down what is the mobility of an electron? It is equal to, means mobility of an electron is equal to drift velocity developed within the electron, or means gained by the electron, developed within electron when 1 volt per meter electric field is applied. Alright, here if it is faint, then I am saying it verbally also, so I hope you will not have any difficulty to write. So this is another important concept you must learn and remember. What is mobility of an electron? Mobility of an electron is equal to drift velocity developed within electron when 1 volt per meter electric field is applied. Alright, so this is called mobility of an electron. Now we will apply the concept of drift velocity to get its relation with the current. Alright, for that what we have done, and this derivation is very important. So you must learn and derive, means practice this derivation. I am repeating, this derivation is important for your board exam. So you must learn the derivation. Now here what we have taken, a conductor of length L and A cross sectional area. We have applied one electric field E along this direction, and due to the electric field, what will happen to the electrons within the conductor? They will drift with the drift velocity in this direction. Alright. And we have considered here N be the concentration of electron. Alright. This is not total number of electron. I repeat, small n is not the total number of electron. In this case, it is the number of electrons per unit volume, which we also say concentration of electrons. Okay. Now, you see here, Vd is the distance travelled by electron per unit time. Isn't it? If Vd be the drift velocity, velocity means what? Displacement or distance travelled in certain direction per unit time. So you see, you can say that Vd is the distance travelled by electron in 1 second. Is that clear? The way I am writing the sentences, everybody should write down. Because in this derivation, these sentences only you have to write. Now, If you multiply the distance traveled with the cross sectional area, then what it will be? It will be the volume, isn't it? Length into cross sectional area is the volume. So if I multiply VD by A, I can write VD into A is the volume swept out by electron in 1 second. Is that clear? Now you see here that one, what is the concentration of electron? Concentration of electron is N, means in unit volume there are N number of electrons. Alright, so you see within VD into A volume, number of electrons, how much it will be? It will be N into VD into A. Clear? I'm repeating. N is the number of electron in unit volume. So in this volume, how many electrons you will have? N into VD into A. Alright. Now, one electron is having charge E. So this electron will be how much charge? N into E into VD into A. So you can say the amount of charge flowing per second or in 1 second through the conductor, THROUGH it is, through the conductor is NEVD into A. Yes or not? This is the number of electron. So if you multiply it by the charge of one electron, what you will get? This is the total charge flowing through the conductor in unit time. Alright. And you know the amount of charge flowing per unit time is known as the current. So what you can write? That current is NEAVD. So this is the relation between current and drift velocity. What does N represent here? Number of electron per unit volume. And remember here, VD, when you will write, you write it properly. You should not write like this, that V into D. Okay, this you should not write. How we will write? V and D is the subscript. Okay, so VD means drift velocity. So what is the relation between current and drift velocity? That current is equal to NEAVD. And how you are getting this derivation? Here actually no derivation is there, only the simple mathematical steps only we are writing, okay? But you please write down all the statement directly. You should not write that I is equal to NEAVD, and please do learn the derivation also. So as current is given by NEAVD, so what will be the current density? Current density is I by A. So you can write it as NEAVD by A. So you are getting NE into VD. Okay? AA getting cancelled. So this is the magnitude of the current density. Now what about the current density if you write it as a vector quantity? The moment you will write it as a vector quantity, then you have to introduce a negative sign. Why? Because I told you, what is the direction of current density? The direction along which the positive charge is moving. Alright. But here, VD when you are writing, it is the velocity of the electron. And you know that positive charge always move opposite to the direction of electron. So what will be the direction of J opposite to VD? That's why this negative sign you have to write when you are giving the vector sign. Alright. So remember these two relations. When you are writing only the magnitude, it will be JNEVD. But when you are writing the vector sign and negative sign, you have to give. Why the negative sign? Because J is opposite to VD. Because J is along the direction of positive charge and electron is negative, and positive charge move always opposite to the direction of the negative charge. Alright, so these are the two relations you have to remember and means retain to answer the conceptual question. At the end of chapter, I will discuss all the conceptual questions. Okay, now we have to derive Ohm's law from this one. Okay, so what is Ohm's law? Everybody knows, when the physical condition and temperature remain constant, then the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across the ends of the conductor. Alright, so we will prove it from the concept of the drift velocity. Alright, so what is the concept of drift velocity? We have got that Vt is equal to A into tau. This is the one relation we have got. Another relation we have got, I is equal to NeAVd. So you see, you are getting drift velocity is I divided by NeA. So this is equation 2. Now if you compare equation 1 and 2, what you can write? Comparing equations 1 and 2, one can write, just you see, you can write I by NeA is equal to A into tau. Alright, again we know this. What is the acceleration of the electron? It is given by EE by M. Again, E can be written by L. So, it is EBML by tau. Is that clear? So, if you consider this relation, then you can write what is V. V is coming I into ML divided by NeA into tau. Alright. So, you see, one can write it like this. It is M into L divided by NeA tau into I. Can you write? V is equal to M into L by NeA tau into I. Okay. Now you see here what you can write from this, that when physical condition means what? I hope you can remember. Physical condition and temperature of the conductor remain constant. Alright. Now what is the meaning? The meaning is that physical condition means length, cross-sectional area. Alright. And the concentration of electron. Because concentration of electron, it varies from material to material, substance to substance. Alright, if you take copper, then the concentration of electron for it is constant. Is that clear? So you see, this term L, A and N, these are the physical condition. Okay, and then temperature of the conductor remain constant. When the temperature will remain constant, then the average relaxation time, as it is depending on temperature, it will remain also constant. Okay, so one can write from this relation that V is equal to some constant into I. Alright, and you know what is the name of this constant? The name of the constant is resistance, isn't it? So you see, resistance R, what is the expression for resistance you are getting? ML divided by NeA tau. Alright. And at the same time, we are getting this relation also. V is equal to some constant into I. It means V is proportional to I. So when V is proportional to I, when physical condition and temperature of the conductor remain constant. Alright, so this is nothing but the Ohm's law. So from the concept of drift velocity, we have proved Ohm's law. I hope it is clear to everyone. I have started with the drift velocity. Then we have taken the relation between the current and drift velocity. Then we have compared this. Then after that, just the substitution of the expression we have done, and we have arrived at this one. And what is this? It is nothing but the Ohm's law. And remember, this quantity, that ml ne tau, it will remain constant only when physical condition and temperature of the conductor remain constant. And remember here, mass of the electron and charge of electron, it does not depend on anything, it is always constant. Okay, so this is the way one can derive Ohm's law from the concept of drift velocity. So what we have got? That resistance R is equal to ML divided by N E square A into tau. This is the relation you must learn and remember. And you also have to remember that I by NEA is equal to EV tau by ML. Or you just remember that resistance is given by this formula. Then V is equal to IR, everybody knows. Just you can put in place of R, that one you will get the same thing. Now, from this relation, you can say the factors on which resistance depends. Alright, now it is so fantastic, you see. Ohm's law we have got, no? Ohm's law, from Ohm's law, we have got the factors on which resistance depends. Now, from the concept of drift velocity, what is the relation we have got? From that one, you can say factors on which resistance depends. Alright, now look at the first one. M is mass of electron, it is constant. E is charge of electron, it is constant. Now, if you consider, you have taken certain substance at certain constant temperature and having constant cross-sectional area, then according to this relation, what you can write? R is directly proportional to L. Just see where L is. L is in the numerator. So if you consider that the other quantities present here, it is constant, you can say that R is directly proportional to length of the conductor. Alright, here you have to remember A, temperature and material. This should be same or this should be constant. Then only R is directly proportional to A. Then second factor, you see, R depends on cross-sectional area. Where is the cross-sectional area? In the denominator. So if you consider the rest of the terms are constant, then you can say R is inversely proportional to cross-sectional area. So inversely proportional to cross-sectional area when the length, temperature and material is same. Is that clear? Then third one, you see, resistance depends on material also. Alright, why? Because concentration of electron, it will change when you will change the material of the substance or the material of the conductor, substance of the conductor. So, what is the third point? That R depends on material. Alright, how R depends on material? Because the N depends on the substance taken. Alright, N depends on substance. N is what? Concentration of electron, means number of electrons per unit value, volume. That is the particular, that is the characteristics of that particular substance. So when you will change the substance, then what will happen? Concentration of electron will change. So the resistance of the material will also change. So you can say resistance depends on the material or substance of the conductor. As substance on the substance, the value of N depends. Okay, then next factor is, now fourth factor you have learnt in 10th standard, that resistance depends on temperature of the conductor. So you see this relation also, it is giving you the same concept. Why? Because this average relaxation time tau, you see, we have taken L, we have taken M and E, you don't have to bother because it is always constant. N also we have taken into consideration, A also we have taken into consideration. So what is left? Left is tau, the average relaxation time. So average relaxation time depends on temperature. Alright, when the temperature increases, then average relaxation time decreases. So what happened? Resistance increases. So you see, as resistance depends on average relaxation time and average relaxation time depends on temperature, so you can make the conclusion that resistance depends on temperature of the conductor. How does it depend? That if temperature increases, then average relaxation time tau decreases. So you see, if tau decreases, what will happen to R? R will increase. Alright, so you see, from this relation one can also find out factors on which resistance of a conductor depends. And you see here, we have got exactly the same concept as we got in 10th standard, that resistance depends on length of the conductor, cross-sectional area of the conductor, material of the conductor and temperature of the conductor. Next is our concept of specific resistance or resistivity of a conductor. You know that resistance is directly proportional to cross-section, directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to cross-sectional area. So one can write R is proportional to L by A. So R is some constant into L by A, and this is the specific resistance. Alright, that was our previous concept. Now, according to this, you see, one is getting rho is equal to R into A by L. Isn't it? Now, what is the expression for R? We have got ML divided by N e square A tau. So, if you substitute R here, now here one thing, cross-sectional area, I have denoted it by big A. So, here also I have to denote by big A. So, you are getting it A by L. So, you see what is the expression for the specific resistance you are getting. It is M into LL cancel, AA cancel. You are getting M by N e square into tau. Alright. So, this is the expression for the specific resistance or electric resistivity of a conductor. So you see, according to this relation, specific resistance, it depends on which factor? It depends on N and tau. Means it depends on the material of the substance, and specific resistance depends on the temperature of the substance. Alright. So these are this relation. You must remember that rho is equal to M by N e square tau. This concept we are getting according to the derivation of the drift velocity. There is another way to write the specific resistance. You see, specific resistance is R into A by L. Now, resistance you can write PD by current. You can write. Now, PD you can write it as electric field multiplied by the length of the conductor. And current you can write it as current density into cross-sectional area. So, you see what is happening. LL cancel, AA cancel. So, rho is equal to E by J. Is that clear? Now, if you consider that electric field E, it is a vector quantity and J is also a vector quantity. So you see, one can write E is equal to rho into J. So this one we are getting, where from you have got this formula? You have got it from the Ohm's law, isn't it? You see, according to Ohm's law it is coming. So E is equal to rho into J. This is also known as vector representation of Ohm's law. Or you see, you can write it like this. J is equal to 1 by rho into E. Isn't it? So 1 by rho is the conductivity. 1 by resistivity is known as the conductivity. I hope you can remember. So J is equal to sigma E. This is the vector representation of Ohm's law. And this is a frequently asked question. Okay, this is vector representation of Ohm's law, that J is equal to sigma E. Alright, so directly you may get the question, and as I am saying, this is a very, very important derivation, whatever we have done here. Alright, and I have not followed what the way it is done in the book. That also I am telling you. So this is, I think this is convenient to do. So that's why you may do like this. And J is equal to sigma E. It is the known as the vector representation of Ohm's law, or Ohm's law in vector form. Okay. So you may get the direct question, that write Ohm's law in vector form. क्लियर? ओम्स लॉ इन स्केलर फॉर्म व्हाट वी राइट, वी इज इक्वल टू आई आर, दिस इज ओम्स लॉ इन स्केलर वन बिकॉज ऑल क्वांटिटीज आर स्केलर हियर. बट इफ यू कंसिडर दिस, दिस रिलेशन वी हैव गॉट फ्रॉम ओम्स लॉ ओनली. But here all the terms here, J and E, they are vector. So this is vector Ohm's law in vector form. So if it comes Ohm's law in vector form, then write down J is equal to sigma E. All right. Sometimes the question comes like this. J is equal to sigma E. What are the symbols represent? Then what does J represent? Current density, I by A. Sigma is the conductivity of the material of the conductor, and conductivity is 1 upon resistivity. You know 1 upon resistance is conductance. Less is the resistance, more it will allow, more it will conduct electricity to pass through it. So that's why always reciprocal of resistance is conductance. So reciprocal of resistivity, it is known as conductivity. So what does sigma represent? Sigma is the conductivity of the conductor, material of the conductor. Conductivity of the material of the conductor. Is that clear? And what does E represent? E is the applied electric field. Clear? So this is, as again I am repeating, very very important topic for your board exam. You must learn whatever written on the board just now. Okay? Each and every steps you must learn. Now we have to find out how the temperature affects the resistivity. Now if you consider a conductor, now I am talking about a conductor, alright. For conductor we have got this relation, again I am repeating, ml by n square a into 1 by tau. Now what is the root mean square? You know that whenever any particle is in random motion, then we define root mean square speed. Alright, root mean square speed means we take the square, then mean, then root of the speed. That already in the thermodynamics chapter in 11th standard, you have done in details. Okay, so I am not going to repeat that one again, that topic again. So if you consider that RMS velocity of the electrons, then RMS velocity is given by mean free path by average relaxation time. So you see, you can write therefore average relaxation time, it will be how much? Mean free path lambda by VRMS. So according to this relation, we know that it is inversely proportional to the average relaxation time resistance. Already I said. Now average relaxation time, you can write it as VRMS divided by time, isn't it? So you see, you can say that R is directly proportional to VRMS. Alright. Again, we know that root mean square, this also we learned in the thermodynamics chapter, that root mean square velocity of a molecules of a gas, it is square root of proportional to square root of absolute temperature, big T I have written, absolute temperature of the substance. Alright. So you see what is happening, electrons, the RMS velocity of electron, it is also directly proportional to the square root of absolute temperature. So what is happening, if you increase temperature, if temperature increases, then what will happen, the RMS speed will increase. And look at the relation, according to this relation, if RMS speed increases, then what will happen, resistance will also increase. Again, you know that resistance is rho into A by L, isn't it? So when resistance will increase, it means what? That specific resistance will also increase. Is that clear? So for conductor, how the resistivity depends on temperature? If temperature increases, then resistivity also increases. And this is the concept. When the temperature will increase, then RMS speed will increase. When RMS speed will increase, resistance will increase. And when resistance will increase, then what will happen to the specific resistance? Specific resistance will also increase. So one can say for conductors, specific resistance increases with increase in temperature. So ultimate one, this final one, I have said verbally, you must note it down. Okay, you write it down this way, that when temperature of a conductor increases, its specific resistance also increases. So resistance depends on temperature according to this formula for a conductor, that RT is equal to R0 into 1 plus alpha T. Okay. Now RT is resistance of the conductor at T degree Celsius, whereas R0 is the resistance at 0 degree Celsius, and alpha is known as the temperature coefficient of resistance, and T is the change in temperature in degree Celsius. Definitely T is the change in temperature. So you see, according to this relation, one can write alpha is equal to RT minus R0 divided by R0 into T. I hope you can remember the thermal expansion. For the thermal expansion, you can remember coefficient of linear expansion, coefficient of superficial expansion. Exactly same kind of thing we have got for resistance. Alright. So what is temperature coefficient of resistance? This is change in resistance divided by original resistance, means the initial resistance, into change in temperature. Alright, so this is the definition of the coefficient of, temperature coefficient of resistance. Alright, so according to this relation also, you see, what is the SI unit of temperature coefficient of resistance? It is per degree Celsius or per Kelvin, because per degree Celsius rise and Kelvin rise, yes, 1 degree Celsius rise and 1 Kelvin rise is same. So you can say, what is the SI unit of alpha? Per degree Celsius or per Kelvin.